So we've talked about electric fields, we talked about electric potential, talked about the connection between them, we talked about conductors, it's like these plates right here. What we haven't done yet is talk about batteries. We're going to do that first, and then we're going to try to put this all together, make some sense of how capacitors work. This is a schematic picture of a battery. The details of what goes on in a battery are appropriate for a chemistry class, and we are not going to spend time on the details of what goes on in a battery other than to say that there are some chemical reactions that happen, at least two of them, and one of the chemical reactions ends up spitting out electrons in the negative side, the negative voltage, negative terminal of the battery, and another chemical reaction gobbles up electrons from the positive side. So electrons are being spit out this way, they're being shoved onto this wire here, and they're being taken from the other side, from the top here. So that's what a battery does. Right now this battery is set at zero voltage. You don't actually get to set your batteries at zero voltage. They stay at whatever voltage they are. So let's make this one 1.5 volts. So what happened when I did that, when I connected this battery up and it's a 1.5 volt battery? What that means is the electric potential here at the top is 1.5 volts higher than the electric potential at the bottom. The negative side is spitting out electrons, that's what I said. So where are the electrons? Well, they're all here on this plate. The tiny little wire is a conductor. The giant plate is a conductor. When you spit electrons onto this conductor, made up of the tiny little wire and the giant plate, the electrons spread out away from each other. And so almost all of them, essentially all of them, are on this plate. Similarly, this reactions that happen in the battery gobbled up electrons from here. And so the positive charge, the electrons still spread out, but they leave only a tiny bit of positive charge on this skinny wire. And almost all of the positive charge, because of the way the electrons spread out, almost all of the positive charge that's left behind is on this giant plate. So you have a positive plate all of a sudden, and a negatively charged plate. The positive plate, of course, is going to be the higher voltage plate. In fact, turns out it's the same voltage, because this is a conductor. Conductors in a static situation, and that's where we are here, we're at a static situation, no charge is moving, conductors have the same voltage. So this from here at the top of the battery all the way over to here is the same voltage. From the bottom of the battery all the way over to this bottom plate is the same voltage. When I connected this battery, in other words, when I went from 0 volts to 1.5, it started spitting electrons out here. So there, for a little short time, there was charge flow as the electrons moved out here, and it gobbled up the battery gobbled up electrons from the top. So charge was flowing, electrons were flowing that way for a while, and then it became a static problem again. After the electrons settled down, all spread out here, and the missing electrons are spread out there, or the positive charge is spread out here, if you want to look at it that way. So positive charge, high voltage, negatively charged plate, low voltage. Not surprisingly, there's going to be an electric field downward from the positive to the negative. You know that from Gauss's law. This is essentially a uniform electric field that depends on how much charge you have here. So it depends on the charge density on this plate, which is the same as the charge density on the lower plate. So if I increase the charge density here, I would get a bigger electric field. If I changed the electric field in some way, that I would have to change the charge density in some way for Gauss's law to still be true. You can get the electric field, it's just the gradient of the voltage, or you can reverse this. The difference in voltage between the top and the bottom is the electric field that's in between times delta Y. Delta Y is the gap between the two plates. There's constant electric field in between them, and that the product of those two gives you the voltage difference between them. The thing that we call capacitance is how much charge we can put on this thing, How much charge can we put on it? Well, I'm going to call it Q, but the capacitance really depends on delta V. Remember when this wasn't, if I go back to zero here, if I actually can go back to 0 volts, so there's no voltage difference between those two. If there's no voltage difference between those two, then they can't be oppositely charged, so there can't be any charge. So the only reason you get a voltage difference is because you cause charge to flow, or conversely, the voltage difference forces these two to have different charges, however you want to put it. Once you apply a voltage difference, the battery forces these two to have different charges. And the amount of the voltage difference depends on the amount of the charge. So I can put any charge I want to on this plate. In that sense, the capacity, you might say its capacity is infinite. The trouble is it would take an infinite voltage. And if it's an infinite voltage, then this will be an infinite electric field, and you can imagine the problems that are going to happen when the electric field gets too big. The forces on the stuff in between are going to be gigantic, and it's going to start ripping atoms apart. So the capacitance really is not just how much charge you put on it, but how much charge you put on it per volt difference between the two. If there was a 1 volt difference, then the charge Q is the capacitance. So I can change capacitors around, and you can see what's going to happen if I do. If I can make the area, I can make this plate area smaller. The voltage is the same, the gap's the same, the electric field's going to be the same. And by Gauss's law, that means the charge density is going to be the same. But if the area is smaller and the charge density is the same, then the total charge is going to be smaller. You can see that because the plate is smaller, the capacitance of that will be smaller. Even at 1.5 volts, it can't carry as much total charge as it did there. Now, the separation between these two is also important, and you can tell because I've already said that the gap determines the electric field if you know the voltage. Well, the voltage is constant, it's 1.5 volts. If I keep the voltage constant, how can I change Q? Well, what happens if I decrease delta Y? If I make that gap smaller, make the separation smaller, if I make that smaller, then either E is going to stay the same and delta V is going to be smaller, or delta V could stay the same and E get bigger, or maybe some combination. So I'm going to make delta Y smaller. What I want to point out is that it's still connected to a battery. Has a voltage difference between the top and the bottom of exactly the same 1.5 volts. So delta V is the thing that's going to stay the same when I make delta Y smaller. In other words, E is going to get bigger. How can E get bigger? Well, let's see what happens. Well, E gets bigger because the charge density gets bigger. Gauss's law, bigger charge density, bigger electric field. So that tells you how the capacitance depends on area, gets bigger with area, and depends on separation. It gets bigger when the separation gets smaller. There are other ways to change the capacitance. I'm just going to mention one of them right now, and that is I can insert what we call a dielectric. This dielectric is just a chunk of insulating material. And I can put it in between because it's an insulator, doesn't have charges that are free to move around. So the negative charges here, the electrons here, can't shoot through this insulator and show up here at the positive side, which would happen if we connect a conductor between these two. But we're not. We're going to push an insulator. I'm going to grab this in a second and move it to the left. But you can see what there's a schematic, a little cartoon picture of what this insulator is. It's a bunch of positive and negative charges. Then the positive and negative charges sit on top of each other. Now, this top plate is positively charged. The bottom plate is negatively charged. There's a downward electric field in between there. If the electric field points down, then positive charge in this dielectric is going to be pushed downward. Negative charge in this dielectric is going to be pushed upward. The top region of this dielectric, this whole top surface, is going to be slightly negatively charged. The bottom surface of this dielectric is going to be slightly positively charged once I push it in there, because the negative charges will be pulled up slightly. The positive charges will be pulled down slightly. Since the bottom will be slightly positively charged, the top will be slightly negatively charged, this dielectric is going to have its own electric field pointing up. It's going to add to the electric field of this thing. This thing has an electric field pointing down right now. When I push this thing in, that electric field will polarize this. It'll polarize it a little bit. This will produce an electric field inside the due to the dielectric that points up. And the total field will be the downward field of the capacitor plus the upward field of the dielectric. So the total electric field between these two plates is going to be smaller than it was. Remember, the gap is going to stay the same. The voltage is going to stay the same. How can the total electric field get smaller? The answer is, it can't. You can see what happened. If the total electric field got smaller, this wouldn't be true anymore. And yet delta V stayed the same and delta Y stayed the same. So this has to be true. The total electric field cannot go down. When you put this dielectric in, it cancels out part of that electric field. If you want to keep the electric field the same, more charge has to flow. More electrons flow around to the bottom. More electrons flow away from the top. And you just get more charge here to produce a bigger downward electric field, canceling out the upward field so that in the end, the total electric field stays the same because the gap and the voltage stayed the same. Now, what did happen though? The electric field stayed the same, and the voltage stayed the same, but the charge on this thing, on these plates, went up. In other words, the charge Q that those plates can carry with the same voltage is now bigger. That means it's a bigger capacitor. It's a bigger capacity for charge carrying. So putting in a dielectric makes the capacitor better, just like increasing the area puts more charge on. And decreasing the spacing puts more charge on. If I make this as big as I can, decrease the spacing as much as I can, make it the best dielectric that I can, and then I get as much charge as I can on that capacitor.